Everyone, how's it going? This is Blue Orc 2792 here to continue my let's play of Total War Warhammer. Game brought to you by Creative Assembly, Sega, and Games Workshop. And I know I said I was bringing this much sooner. Well, the idea was to make the video and then post it a few hours after my part 7, but the game kept crashing. So that idea was scrapped, but I hear it back and hopefully it doesn't crash again. Continuing where I left off, besieging Karthag as Karthag. Only one more siege tower to go. Then I'm gonna bring the pain against Bokey Longname and Hadras of Baden. And I could probably take out a raid stance. Yeah. Is there anything I can do? Nope, doesn't look like it, so I'm gonna end my turn.
You've got mail.
Populated surplus, death pass. Nice. Constructed complete is heap of shiny stuff. Heap of shiny stuff like a pile, but bigger. Alright, got everything I needed. So I'm just go ahead and take Karthag as Karthag. Yeah. Oh, and I noticed this is labor force. This is what you use to make your siege weapons. And labor force available per turn is the amount of labor you can use per turn to construct siege engines. That's pretty neat. That way you don't like spam Batarang Man towers for as long as you wish. Okay, do I have everything I need? Yes I do, so fight battle. Alright, so risk magic for more favorable winds. Alright, I'm gonna try this gamble thing. See, what do you got for me? Ooh, nice. Now I have 22 power at the start of the fight instead of 5. Ronald is with you. Oh, nice. Okay, now start deployment. Okay, so I'm gonna have two reinforcement armies. And I guess I should. I'll start with this side since I'm. Once my guys are already over here. So. Black Orcs. Go over here. Four on that side. Four on this side. Alright. And Wolf Riders are here. Where's my archers? Over here, and okay, those are boar boys. Okay, once my reinforcement comes, they're gonna back up my assault. Grimgor, you join your black orcs. Mash Ironjaw, you back up these orc boys. Alright, and Goblin Spearman, you are gonna assist the orc boys. They're gonna bash down the gate. And Krulugmork's chosen. You're gonna assist in the when the gate is breached as well. And your board is gonna assist that flank. I have everything I need. I think I do. Alright, so start the battle. Wolf Riders, head over there. And get you over there. Alright. Let's do this. Ooh, my reinforcements have showed up. Okay, so there, you're gonna assist that breach. You over there, you over there. Oh. The other two orc boys, you assist that breach. You're going to assist that breach. And okay, my rock lobbers haven't showed up yet. Here, and you'll help assist the breach as well.
Send troops to capture the enemy defenses, Commander. They can be turned to our service.
Yeah, I heard you already, Anthony Hopkins.
Thank you.
And booyah! Direct hit. Okay, enough fun time. Okay, the breach has commenced. Victory's in our grasp. Oh, neat. There we go. Gates are destroyed. Push forward. Where's my spearman? Boyz, Wolf Riders, you charge in too. Oh man, they're on the wrong side. Oh yeah, they're about to get outflanked. Badly. Rock lobbers, target the quarrelers. Doom divers, you do the same. Grimgor, go kick Bokey Longnames' ass. Where's the Wolf Rider Archers? And victory. Hold on 1 second. It ain't over until that Dwarf Lord's dead. As long as that Dwarf Lord lives, he can raise an army to oppose me. And almost got him. All of the orcs are pouring down from the walls just to get this Dwarf Lord. And I just forgot that I actually had Winds of Magic at my disposal. Wait. Where's Tricky Spitebacker? Oh, he's hanging in the back. It wouldn't even make a difference. Enemy Lord is dead. Now I can end the battle. Champion of the Common Man, Metru was beloved by those he protected. Whenever he fought, the peasants doubled their efforts and would fight to the death rather than dishonor their lord. Virtue of empathy. And I have effectively conquered the dwarves. Thorgrim Grudgebearer is dead. The Slayer King Ogrim Ironfist is I slain. And there I have no legendary lords to oppose me. And I didn't even take that much losses. Yep, decisive victory. Duke gained a lot of money. Ranking. I haven't made level 9 yet. Occupy. Bokey long name, our enemy belonging to the dwarves has perished in battle like Karaz at the Silver Road. Weapon gained. Warrior Bane. Now suddenly weapon spread curse on all around. This would be the enemy warrior of their martial skills. Oh, nice. Province secured. We gained complete control of the province. It is now possible to issue commandment across the land. I got Karaz's Karak as my own. Dwarves have been obliterated. There's nothing left apart from echoing laughter of the thirsting gods. Alright. Let's see, what can I build? Ooh. I really want some orc biggins and see what the night goblins can do. I almost forgot. My goblin big boss. Well, they did what they needed to do. Now I'm gonna have them. Wait, what was Good Snake again? Carry out a successful assassination attempt against one characters belonging to the following races: Greenskin tribes. Okay, so I'll just have them assassinate someone up here from Blazebeers, because I pretty much wiped out the dwarves for them. It should be cool. Oh. Night Goblin Great Shaman. Let's see. Gork will fix it. Minus speed and charge bonus. Ooh, that is pretty useful. We'll go with that. Alright, and... okay, now honestly, I think now it's time to start downsizing to save some money. Merge. And disband. Same thing with you, boys. Boot. And you get the boot. Because I have now access to spider riders. Which are pretty sure are a lot better than the wolf riders. Hold on. Yeah, way better than wolf riders. Ready for murdering. And want to do an exchange of units, so the goblin rock lovers for the spearmen. And yep, that's it for me. So, oh, a commandment. Forgot about that.
Over territory you rule, my lord. Make the effort to rouse the populace, so that they may better serve your ends.
Yeah, I got that, Anthony Hopkins. Okay, so what do we have here? Brag about the boss. Growth and obedience rates. Okay, so I'm gonna switch out money for obedience so I don't end up having rebellion. Raiding by Krellug Mork shows a greenskin wog. So it was affecting local obedience. Yeah, oh, and the wog just disbanded. The boys have ran out of things to fight and have started lamping each other instead. Grimwar's I heard wogs no more. Find them, and it means you want to get back in Gork's favor. Yes, I'm aware of this population surplus. No. Oh. Now it's plus 3. Oh, this was obedience plus 2, so...
Let's go.
Yeah. I'm gonna get Grimgor and Grum back to Black Crag. Tricky, you can hang out here at Karaz Askarak. And my big goblin big bosses head up north. And yep, end my turn. Spider boom, the warm dance. Weather of late has created ideal conditions in nests and hatcheries of forest spiders. The great spider god is praised for his generosity. Oh, nice. Ooh. Orc begins. I really like me some biggins. Let's see now. What can I do? Well, I can always just get another wolf den. And that sounds good. Take the underpassage.
Here.
Big boss, you have to up north.
What you want? Can it be quick?
You head up north too. Okay, now I'm done with the dwarves. I'm gonna go ahead and pick a fight with Karak Azul. And yeah, it's gonna lead me directly into a fight with Braddock Var. I should be able to handle Braddock Var. As long as I'm pretty sure the border prisons aren't gonna get into a fight. End my turn. Thief Natchez wants to bring in a defensive alliance with me. Bragvar is getting pretty damn powerful, so... And they're willing to offer me money. So... Alright, I accept. I'm gonna need one of you guys to live, so... What about Top Knots? Can I get into an alliance with them as well?
Alright, you got my attention. What's your tribe want?
Thank you. Oh, there are enemies. Okay, so... Oh, well. Ooh, Cave of Shinies. Let me get me that.
Yes, boss. This way. Me. Get going.
There we go. And end my turn. Dave Natchez got obliterated. Oh, by the top knots. Well, all right.
Let's get one thing understood. I'm the boss here.
Oh, you ain't the boss. Can I offer any some sort of, like, non-aggression pact? Or what's military axe? Okay, that's low. Savage orc tribes. So okay, so enter non-aggression pact with them. Oh yeah, I can get the occupied Karaza's Karak. Get that right there. Okay, does that have to be an actual lord, or can I just assassinate one of them? Okay, one characters. Okay, one character is in the army. I can do that. Assassinate that goblin right there, then run like hell. The omens are ill. Some you have done has angered the gods, yet they are fickle. They may forgive you in time, more immediacy might be necessary. Okay, I'm dealing with an obedience crisis, so... Fine, here's your tribute. Ooh, technology unlocked. And... You know what? I'm gonna get the better stickers. If nothing else, for my garrison forces. Nah, it's being assassination. Oh.
On it. Boss. On the way.
Okay, yeah, I can do an assassination attempt on one of them. A much better outcome. See how much this guy's. Yeah, no, I'm just gonna save my money. And go right back to extortion. Alright, now let's see here. Orc Biggins. Let's do a comparison. They have better armor. They're not shielded. But I think the fact they have better armor and more health, I think it's going to balance that out. Better leadership. Better melee attack and defense. Better weapon strength and charge bonus. Oh, no. Let's see, damage dealer. This unit has a strong emphasis on dealing damage. If fighting it, make sure to take it out before we can get into firing or melee range. Biggins are the heaviest, strongest minions of orcs. Biggins are eager to prove against the enemies of all sizes. So, damage. This unit inflicts additional damage when fighting enemies that are cavalry size or larger. That's a lot. Hey, that is a lot. Oh, nope, didn't mean that. Okay, let's do a comparison with the goblins and night goblins. They have 25 armor, same amount of health, less armor, less leadership. This one's a better charge bonus and is poison attack. I get that to be expected, but let's do the real comparison between the goblin archers and the night goblins. More health, but less armor, but armor's not going to make that much of a difference because they're archers. Probably just going to get killed anyways. Leadership, speed's about the same, melee attack's a bit better, as well as basically melee overall. Okay, so the only real difference is poison attacks. Poison attack unit weakens the target's speed and damage while increasing its vigor. Okay, so poison seems to be very, very useful. What else? Okay, and comparison between the Wolf Riders and the Spider Riders. So, more health, more armor, more leadership, not as fast, poison attacks, and better in melee combat, and better charge bonus. So, wait, what about the four Spider Riders? Four, not as fast, but yeah, better at everything. How much I can recruit? 700. Alright, so I'll wait for that later. And just end my turn right now.
Undead, my lord. Under the thrall of their vampire masters, no doubt. Stay alert when dealing with the midnight aristocracy, lest their treachery overtake you.
Well, good thing I have the blade spears as a buffer. something Transylvanian. Midnight aristocracy, a long strike tear into the hearts of the mortal races. From their lairs deep in Sylvania, the vampires strike out against the living in their massed armies of eager dead. Non-vampire armies will suffer attritional casualties when in vampire-held territory and vice versa. Vampire faction can raise the dead, allowing them to quickly build massive armies. Vampiric influence in a province is measured as corruption. A vampire's upright will occur if corruption is allowed to grow unchecked. Alright. Ooh. Is... Use action. Fuck it, I'm going for trying to assassinate him. Assassination failure.
What?
All right. Fuck it, go for it. I need this guy dead. And failure. Nice going. Gonna have one damn job. Just give me an orc biggin.
Ready for murdering.
And you guys, you are all getting the boot. Hold on. Missile damage, right? 19. Okay, 19 plus poison. Weak against armor, Vanguard deployment. Yep, goblin archers, you're getting the boot. In favor of the night goblins.
Start the war!
Now they'll see.
End my turn. Okay, they want military access in exchange for money. I'd rather not have a pissed off faction, so yeah, go ahead. You're basically my buffer. Assassinate, positive outcome. Alright, I'm going for it. Failure.
I'll take him out, boss.
You ever earn some experience?
Orcs will.
Okay, good. There, you get the assassin. Okay, so. Okay, can we do that in global? Oh. Oh yeah, that's right. Trying to save up to upgrade my stronghold. Okay. Pop the surplus silver road. There you go. Now Grimgora and Biggins. Wait, which one has a better chance of getting the deed done? Oh yeah, this one does. So come on. Damn it.
What?
You get the assassin buff too. Just kill the damn character. Oh well.
Let's go.
Oh yeah, I'm gonna get me some night goblin archers. And so I'm gonna end. Hold on, wait. Is there anything else I can do before I do that? Well, guess not, since I don't have a lot of money. But anyway, yeah, I'm gonna end part 8 right here. I hope everyone enjoyed this. If you did, feel free to like, share, and subscribe. And I will see you all next time.